Hello, this is Eric. Have you heard about the OpenHaystack? This makes you create your own Apple's AirTag. To be exact, it makes your device look like Apple's AirTag. This is so cool. It means the nearby iPhones upload the location information of the AirTag you made. I prepared 3 AirTags with ESP32 for testing. This is my ESP32 with ePaper, and now it works as an AirTag. It has no battery, so I had to put the battery on the back. The reason I use this is that it's the smallest of ESP32s I have. There is no particular reason. A long time ago, I have a project to upload emoji into this from mobile application. If you need more information about this device and what I did, please check out my channel. I leave this in my car and go back to my office. Also, I made ESP32 rolling 32 write to AirTag to check my office location. As you can see on the screen, the location of my car and my office are displayed on the map. The actual parking structure is where the P-mark is, but it has not been properly updated yet. On the bottom of the screen, the key icon shows the location of my office. The positioning is going well because there are many Apple products around. What if I leave an AirTag in a moving vehicle? Will it update properly or not? I need to go to USPS to pick up my packages, so it's a good time to try it. The location has been updated here. While waiting for the red turn signal, the location of my car seems to have been updated by someone's iPhone at the arrow location. Let's keep going. I arrived at the USPS. Unfortunately, there were no updates for 3 minutes. It seems that there are no Apple devices nearby to update my AirTag's current location. Now it's time to head back to my office. A few minutes later, it updated my new location again. Finally, I got to the parking structure again. It looks like it was updated once again by someone else just before entering the parking structure. The third AirTag I prepared is this. I put the rolling 32 write board and battery in a tic-tac case. If we can decorate more, we can make more private AirTags. That's gonna be cool too. Also, I leave this in my wife's car, so probably I can track where she's going. Of course, I mentioned this in advance and she agreed to help me with my experiment. I'm ready to track my wife's car. Nice. Her car has started moving and the first updated location is here. Perhaps the device of someone living here detected my AirTag, stopped it on the road, and updated its location. Similar to the test that I did, it's updating the location information occasionally. Not bad. The time to get the current location is 11:30, and after 3 minutes again, I get the updated location. The AirTag in my office is updated within a minute or two at the earliest. Probably the fastest update time is 1 minute, and under normal circumstances, it seems to update every 3 to 5 minutes on average. If there are no Apple devices nearby, you may have to wait a long time as your AirTag's location cannot be updated. And another 3 minutes later, I can receive new location information again. Perhaps her destination is around here. Exactly 3 minutes later again, the new location is updated. It's working great. It seems to be parked. This time, I will compare the location to the GPS installed in the vehicle. Since this is GPS information, it's showing the vehicle's location very accurately. Also, because it's parked outdoors, the accuracy is very high. Comparing the two locations, there seems to be a difference of about 3 meters, I guess. This is a very satisfactory level. Honestly, I'm very happy with this result. Being able to access Apple's Find My Network through this OpenHaystack is like a dream come true. Their magic key acquisition through reverse engineering is amazing. And using a custom plugin to get location reports from Apple's email is also great. These are all implementations of Apple's accessories in terms of software. OpenHaystack shows how it works in detail on their GitHub page, so please take a look at that. One thing I want to add here is actually Apple's AirTag is using not only BLE but also UWB chip to enable precise positioning at close range. If I can merge my UWB project with this OpenHaystack project, I think we can make something like Apple's AirTag for real. That's really cool. Today's video ends here. Hopefully you guys found this video useful. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.